What's up, you guys? I'm Tony Metro, and today we are going to be discussing some of the latest MLB rumors, including where George Springer and DJ LeMahieu may sign, as well as a potential trade partner for Francisco Lindor. And if you guys enjoy this video, be sure to leave it a like and subscribe to my channel so you can stay up to date on all of the latest rumors throughout the MLB offseason. But I mean, like, you don't have to. It would be nice, though. Moving on, let's jump right into the George Springer news. So according to Jeff Passan of ESPN, Major League executives believe that the race for George Springer has come down to two teams, the Toronto Blue Jays and the New York Mets. Earlier in the offseason, Buster only tweeted that he was ready to bet his family farm that George Springer was bound to sign with the New York Mets. But the Toronto Blue Jays are also expected to have a very busy offseason and add to that young core that brought them to the playoffs for the first time since 2015. As I've noted in some of my other videos, the Blue Jays had Randall Grichuk in center field last year, so adding a player like George Springer would be a huge upgrade for them. In 2020, George Springer had a .265 average, a .359 on base percentage, and a .540 slugging percentage. He also added 14 home runs and 43 RBIs. George Springer is reportedly seeking a contract for 5 years and $125 million. Now, last year and at the age of 31, George Springer still continued to play a very solid center field. But as every MLB fan base has experienced before, some players' careers just start to taper off as they enter their 30s. I don't think George Springer is going to sign a long-term contract and all of a sudden become a dud. But given his age, the Mets, the Blue Jays, and any team that's interested in Springer have to be wary about how many more years he can play center field for. Again, the defensive metrics don't show that Springer has lost a step out there. Not yet, at least. But if that changes and Springer needs to be moved to one of the corner outfield positions, he's still going to be getting paid like a two-way center fielder. Despite all of that, as a Mets fan, I am all in on George Springer. The Mets have not had a true two-way center fielder since Carlos Beltran in his prime, and adding George Springer to this roster would immediately make the Mets one of the most lethal lineups in baseball. But it also makes a tremendous amount of sense for the Blue Jays to pursue George Springer. With the emergence of the Blue Jays' young core, they are ready to keep adding to this team and compete with the Yankees and the Rays for the AL East. Adding a clutch veteran with amazing postseason numbers would be a huge acquisition to move that needle for them. I definitely expect either the Mets or the Blue Jays to sign George Springer, but the other team could always go after Jackie Bradley Jr., who is also a free agent this offseason. Next, let's move on to DJ LeMahieu. And again, we're going to be talking about the Toronto Blue Jays. Jeff Passan also reported that the Blue Jays have emerged as serious contenders for DJ LeMahieu. This coming on the heels of last week's reports that the Yankees and DJ LeMahieu's representation are far apart on potential contract negotiations for the All-Star second baseman. Passan noted that this may be a backup plan for the Blue Jays if they swing and miss on George Springer. But if the Jays do somehow steal DJ LeMahieu away from the Yankees, it would be a massive gut punch and power shift in that division. In his 2 seasons with the Yankees, LeMahieu has cemented himself as one of baseball's best players and has far exceeded the expectations of the team when they signed him 2 years ago. But the Yankees are a calculated organization and they never give out contracts for past performance. I mean, I guess except for Jacoby Ellsbury. So that being said, I don't see the Yankees caving to DJ LeMahieu's demands, but I do still think he will end up on the team. The Yankees know how valuable of a player LeMahieu is to that team and how much of a fan favorite he is. Like I said, DJ LeMahieu was asking for a 5-year deal worth $125 million. But DJ LeMahieu is 32, and just like I touched on George Springer, you never really know who's going to keep playing well into their 30s and who's going to go on the decline. The Yankees are a little more money conscious this year than in the past, but I don't think they're going to let it get in the way of them bringing back LeMahieu. And the last rumor that I have for you guys today comes again from Jeff Passan, and again involves the Toronto Blue Jays. According to Jeff Passan, the Toronto Blue Jays as well as the New York Mets are two teams that are interested in trading for Francisco Lindor. I recently made a video, a Mets trade proposal for Francisco Lindor, which I'm going to link right up here if you want to check that out. So I won't talk about the Mets too much on this one. Before we even discuss Francisco Lindor on the Blue Jays, the team needs to figure out what they would do with their current shortstop, Bo Bichette. Bichette was one of the members of the trio of promising prospects that came up together for the Blue Jays, along with Vladdy Jr. and Kevin Biggio. And the results on the early part of his career are pretty good. In 319 career at-bats, Bo Bichette has a 347 on base percentage and a 137 OPS plus. And he's also been really solid in the field at shortstop. In 2019, he was worth plus 4 defensive runs saved in just 42 games. But last year, in just 26 games, Bichette was worth negative 1 defensive runs saved at shortstop. I'm not concerned about that. The shortened season was a weird one. The Blue Jays didn't even play in their home ballpark. So if the Blue Jays felt they could move Bichette elsewhere on the diamond, who would they have to send back in a trade for Francisco Lindor? The Cleveland Indians desperately need some production from their outfield, so I have to imagine that it would begin with Lourdes Gurriel Jr. Gurriel Jr. had his breakout season in 2020 with an 882 OPS, which ranked third among all left fielders behind only Juan Soto and Eloy Jimenez. The next player going in that trade would probably be shortstop prospect Jordan Groshans. Groshans was selected by the Blue Jays with the 12th overall pick in the 2018 draft. Groshans is 21 years old, 6'3", and has spent time at second base in addition to shortstop. And according to MLB.com, he is ranked as the number 70 overall prospect in the game. Even after Gurriel and Groshans, the Blue Jays still may need to kick in another player or two to get that deal done. And that all without even discussing a potential extension for Lindor and the Blue Jays. In the end, the price might be high, but adding a player like Francisco Lindor to that roster immediately makes the Blue Jays contenders in the AL East. So that concludes today's big news and rumors from around the league. Do you think George Springer will sign with the Mets or the Blue Jays? Where will DJ LeMahieu end up signing, and what kind of contract will he get? And who's in a better position to trade for Francisco Lindor, the Mets or the Blue Jays? I want to hear from you guys. Let me know in the comment section below. Thank you guys for watching. I have been your host, Tony Metro.